In school literacy, observe. One of the first things I observed when walking into Mrs. White's fifth grade classroom was the classroom setup. Desks were arranged into teams, which contained four or five students each. This arrangement allowed the students to easily discuss classroom activities and promoted teamwork and community. The classroom contained a classroom library where students could choose from a variety of readings. The library was separated by genre and was made up of over 100 books. Each morning, the class followed the same routine, transitioning from whole to part, to writing, to science, and finally to math. I decided to participate in the first activity of whole to part, the word of the day. Participate. Each morning, Mrs. White transitions from whole to part into writing workshop through the word of the day. I chose to analyze the word of the day as my in-class literacy activity as it is rich in literacy practices. Oftentimes, students break off into groups for their lessons, but the class as a whole does the word of the day. Therefore, I observed this activity by simply sitting in as if I were a student myself. Mrs. White controls the flow of this activity, standing at the front of the classroom and recording students' observation on a poster paper chart. This chart includes the word of the day from each day of the week, reminding the students of definitions already learned. Separated into four columns, the chart contains the word, its inferred meaning, clues that led students to deduce its meaning, and an original sentence that uses the word. Analyze. In relation to text used during this activity, the analyzed word is selected out of Story Works, a collection of stories that are adapted based on a child's reading level. Each student has a copy of the text, which they interact with by highlighting not only the word of the day, but also surrounding clues that help them infer its meaning. Code breaking is used throughout the entirety of this activity, as the objective of the activity is to have students decode a selected word. In order to facilitate code breaking, Mrs. White has students draw on their background knowledge of both the word in general and the word in context. For example, when the word of the day was Marine, students first thought of a person in the military. Noting that the given text was a nonfiction piece about water sources, students were able to conclude that this could not be the preferred definition. Students also code break by analyzing clues surrounding the word. One student noted that Marine was preceded by a sentence that mentioned the lock, which means lake. From here, the class was able to confirm their beliefs that marine must be water-related. In order to confirm that they have in fact decoded the term's meaning, the students end the activity by writing a sentence that correctly uses the term. The key vocabulary in this literacy community is those words associated with code-breaking the word's meanings. Students must know what it means to infer and must understand the concept of background knowledge. Aside from these terms, the key vocabulary changes depending on the text used, as each story in StoryWorks has a different theme and, therefore, different vocabulary associated with it. A student is fluent in this literacy community when he is able to pick up on surrounding evidence to determine the meaning of a word without prompting from the teacher. In other words, he is able to successfully decode a word's meaning on his own, understanding the importance of context. A participant in this community knows that he has comprehended meaning when he is able to write a sentence with the word that uses the word in the same context as that in the text. Moreover, comprehension is gauged based on whether or not one recognizes the word the next time it is read. To be fluent means to read through the story works and understand each of the five words that have been previously defined. It also means using one's knowledge of how to decode a language to uncover the meaning of other unfamiliar words. Code-breaking vocabulary is a process that one becomes fluent in when he is able to do it from start to finish on his own. One skill that is necessary for students to be successful during this literacy activity is the ability to make use of the four-resource model. More specifically, students must act as both code breakers and text participants. As code breakers, students must call on basic skills required of readers, such as understanding simple vocabulary and being a fluent reader. As text participants, students must use skills that allow them to call upon prior knowledge and experiences. By simply reading the text and connecting it to instances in their own lives, students are better able to discern the meaning. Without the skills of a text participant, the word of the day would be useless because the student would be unable to recognize a word based on its context. With this in mind, understanding that words can have multiple meanings based on context is important prior knowledge for the student. Moreover, the student should already have basic knowledge on parts of speech so as to allow him to understand the form of the word in which he is defining. Prior knowledge of the story itself is important as well, which is why Mrs. White has the students read through the piece before selecting the word of the day. Knowing the main idea of the story will allow the students to confidently select the desired definition of the word based off of context. Being successful during this activity comes not only from what the student knows, but also what he is taught. Here, the student must be taught the steps to decoding a word's definition, so that he can move step by step in order to eventually infer its correct meaning. These practices are taught through repetition, as Mrs. White goes over each step in front of the class daily. If students are still unable to remember the steps, they can be found on the chart in the front of the classroom. Moreover, students must be taught that words are able to have more than one meaning based on how they are used. This is taught by having students use background knowledge to infer the meaning of the word and then pulling textual evidence out of the story to show them why this is not the correct meaning for this context. Mrs. White motivated the students to pay attention and to participate in the Word of the Day activity by reminding them that it would help them in becoming better readers. One can easily prove that he has participated in this literacy activity by making use of the newly learned vocabulary in everyday conversation. Using this vocabulary correctly not only proves to another that you are a participant, but when used correctly also proves that the literacy event was successful. By the end of the school year, Mrs. White's students will not only have a wide variety of vocabulary, but will also have improved reading skills due to their ability to infer the meaning of unknown words. Observe. For my out-of-school literacy practice, I decided to observe a friend who plays acoustic guitar at her church. Sitting in on her rehearsals, I was able to watch her learn an unfamiliar piece from start to finish. Before practicing each time, she had a series of steps she had to go through to ensure that the guitar was ready. First, she used a Laurin guitar pitch pipe to tune the guitar. Then she adjusted the guitar strap to her liking before strumming a couple of chords to double-check that everything was ready. From here, she used chords found online to play through the selected songs. Some musicians play to written music, but my friend finds it easier to play by chords. Participate. After watching my friend through several rehearsals, I decided that I wanted to learn how to play the guitar. With Lauren's help, I learned all the vocabulary necessary to succeed as a guitarist, as well as the basic foundations on how to play chords. My goal as a participant was to learn how to play the song Sanctuary by third day. A song comprised of only three chords, A, D, and G. My first lesson was on how to play each of these three chords. After I had memorized the fingering for each, Lauren assisted me in learning how to move between each chord in a fluid and timely manner. Although this sounded simple, it was not, and it took me many hours to finally master the transitions. Analyze. Several different texts are used within the guitarist community. Some guitarists are able to play by looking at sheet music, but Lauren taught me to play by chords. Sheet music is owned by a publishing company and must be purchased, but chords can easily be found online. The progression of chords that I used for Sanctuary was found on ultimateguitar.com, but there are hundreds of other sites that contain the chords not only for this song, but thousands of others as well. Code breaking in this activity involved understanding the meaning of and fingering for different chords. Pressing your fingers down on a different combination of strings produces each chord. Therefore, I was unable to learn the music until I was able to memorize the fingering of each. This took a good amount of time, but once I had decoded the three chords, learning to play the song was a breeze. The key vocabulary for this community first includes the parts of the guitar. There's the head of the guitar, the neck, and the body. The player's non-dominant hand is placed on the neck of the guitar, where it then presses the strings against the fret. In doing so, the string vibrates and a note is produced. Each time the player moves up a fret, the pitch of the note increases by a half note. It is on the fret that the player produces a chord, which is three or more notes sounded simultaneously. Another important term for guitarists to know is capo. A capo is a clamp that is pressed down on the strings of a particular fret in order to raise the tune by a predetermined amount. Some guitarists pick single notes one at a time, but I learned to play by strumming, which consists of brushing across strings in a rhythmic up and down fashion. A person is fluent in this community when he is able to unconsciously play a given chord. Along with having the fingerings of each chord memorized, he must also be able to transition his fingers between chords without hesitation. In this way, a person is fluent when the song flows without any bumps along the way. Because music is a common feature of everyday life, it is easy to determine if someone has comprehended how to play the guitar. Any listener can most likely pick up on someone who has not comprehended the skill, as the music will be choppy and chords played will not match the pitch of the rest of the music. Along with sound, you can pick up on if someone has comprehended how to play the guitar by simply watching their face. If they know what they are doing, they will most likely appear confident, but if they are lost and playing the wrong notes, their face will most likely reflect their mistakes. In order to be successful at playing the guitar, one must simply approach the task with the readiness to learn. Prior musical knowledge is helpful, but not a necessity. Without this knowledge, the learner will simply have to spend more time learning musical theory before diving into the actual playing of the guitar. Success in this community comes with the understanding that being a fluent guitarist does not come overnight. Rather, it takes practice. Upon first beginning lessons, practice is necessary in order to build calluses on your fingers. Pushing the strings down against the fret is challenging, as the player must push with a good deal of force. Therefore, the buildup of calluses allows this to be done with greater ease. In this community, it is not what you already know that ensures your success, but rather what you were taught. One must first learn the parts of guitar and how to tune it prior to rehearsal. He must then learn the makeup of chords and how to determine the key of a piece. From here, he can learn how to strum between different chords and how to carry the tempo of a song. In other words, learning the guitar is a step-by-step process that must be built upon little by little. Another individual who is already fluent in guitar playing most easily teaches these practices. With their prior knowledge, they are able to help the beginning player learn how to place his fingers and can demonstrate when necessary. Learning a new skill is easier when you are able to watch it be done successfully by another, and this proves true in learning a guitar. Moreover, the skilled guitarist is able to introduce the new participant to key vocabulary and can remind him of it along the way. The motivation to learn to play the guitar generally comes from a personal desire. For me, I simply wanted to be able to lead worship at my church back home. This motivation may differ for others, spanning from hoping to one day join a band to simply wanting to learn to play for fun. One can demonstrate that he is a member of the guitar playing community by using musical terms, such as chord and fret, in casual conversation. Moreover, when listening to music, he will be able to pick up on minor details that only a musician would recognize, such as changes in tempo. Many guitarists are fluent in the different types of guitars and can name them by look and sound, but simply being able to list chords and parts of the guitar are enough to show that one participates in this community. Learning to play the guitar has always been a dream of mine, and I am so excited to now have the knowledge necessary to play simple songs. I am by no means prepared to go out and join a band, but with enough practice and engagement within this literacy community, anything is possible.